Hello everybody, this is Dr. Tani Issa, Professor of Pathology. I make these videos for all medical students. Hope someone may find it helpful. We're still talking about syphilis. Today we are going to talk about the tertiary stage of syphilis. And you know that the tertiary stage of syphilis occurs in about one-third of untreated patients after a latent period of 5 years or more. Now, what are the lesions of the tertiary stage of syphilis? The lesions of tertiary stage of syphilis occur mainly due to hypersensitivity reaction and also due to ischemia and fibrosis. What type of hypersensitivity reaction? You know that it is type 4 hypersensitivity reaction, delayed type hypersensitivity reaction, which causes granuloma, like tuberculous granuloma and other granulomatous disease. And we call it Gumma. In syphilis, we call this granuloma Gumma. And the lesion may also occur. This is the Gumma. This is the Gumma. And it is like tuberculous granuloma, but the difference is that the inflammatory infiltrates consist mainly of plasma cells. And there is also macrophage and lymphocytes, and it is surrounded by fibroblasts. You can see the fibrosis here surrounding this granuloma, and it shows central necrosis, but it doesn't show the caseation of tuberculous granuloma. So the hypersensitivity is type 4 hypersensitivity reaction, and it forms a syphilitic granuloma, which we call it gamma. And of course, gamma will cause destruction of the tissues. The other lesion is the diffuse syphilitic reaction. And diffuse syphilitic reaction is inflammatory infiltrate, consists mainly of plasma cells and lymphocytes. And it also consists of endarthritis obliterans. Endarthritis obliterans is obliteration or narrowing and obliteration of the small arterioles and arteries also. Small arterioles becomes narrowed by the proliferation of the intima and also by the inflammation of the wall and the perivascular cuffing consists mainly of lymphocytes and numerous plasma cells. This narrowing of the vessels will cause ischemia and fibrosis of the tissues. And these lesions, the lesions of tertiary stage of syphilis, are not very infectious as those of primary and secondary stage of syphilis because the organisms are scant. The organisms now are scant because of the hypersensitivity reaction, the immune reaction. But in spite of the immune reaction, the organisms are still there. This means that immune reaction in syphilis is not very efficient because you can see the disease progress from primary stage to secondary stage to tertiary stage. And even in the tertiary stage, you can still find some organisms. So the immune reaction in syphilis is not very efficient. And though the lesions are not very infectious, but they are very destructive to the tissues and the organs. What are the manifestations of tertiary syphilis? You can see the cardiovascular system affected. In fact, syphilis affects two main systems of the body, the cardiovascular system and the nervous system. And so you can see cardiovascular syphilis or neurosyphilis and the so-called benign tertiary syphilis, in which you can see multiple gamma affecting many organs and the tissues of the body. These lesions may occur alone or in combination. What is the cardiovascular syphilis? In cardiovascular syphilis, you can see affection of the aorta, heart, and the coronary arteries. The aorta is affected by what is called syphilitic aortitis or thoracic aortic aneurysm, or we call it sometimes leutic aneurysm. This is affection of the ascending aorta. The ascending aorta is the most commonly affected part of the aorta, followed by the aortic arch and then the descending aorta. And it consists of inflammation and scarring and weakness of the wall, which leads to dilatation and aneurysm formation. How this happens? Let's see. This is the wall of the aorta and large vessels. You know that the wall of aorta and large vessels consist of three layers, intima, media, and adventitia. And the intima consists of a single layer of endothelial cells with intimal connective tissue. And this intima is separated from the media by a dense elastic membrane called the internal elastic membrane or internal elastic lamina. And the media is formed mainly of smooth muscle cells and elastic fibers. And media consists more than two-thirds of the thickness of the aorta. And it is separated from the adventitia by a dense elastic membrane called the external elastic membrane or external elastic lamina. And the adventitia is formed mainly of connective tissue and blood vessels and the nerve endings. You know that the intima and the inner half of the media receives oxygen and the nutrient by direct diffusion from the vessel lumen. But this is also facilitated by holes in the internal elastic membrane. But this diffusion from the lumen is not sufficient for the outer half of the media. So the outer half of the media and the adventitia are nourished by small vessels, which come from outside the aorta, from outside the vessel, small vessels. And these vessels are rising from outside the vessel and called vasa vasora. Vasa vasora means the vessels of the vessels because they supply the wall of the aorta, which is a vessel. So literally, it is vessels of the vessels. These vessels or vasa vasora traverse the adventitia into the media to nourish the outer part of the media, because the media must be healthy, because you know that the elastic tissue is very important for the aorta. The media consists of the smooth muscle fibers and the elastic fibers. And you know that the elastic fibers are very important. Why? Because the heart pumps blood in systole into the aorta. So the aorta must distend to accommodate this blood. And in diastole, it recoil again to distribute blood to the different tissues, to the branches and different tissues. And so for this extension and recoil, this needs healthy elastic fibers. So in syphilitic aortitis, you see what happened in syphilitic aortitis. Syphilitic aortitis is caused by endarthritis obliterans of these vasa vasora, which means proliferation of the intimal lining of these vasa vasora and inflammation of its wall by infiltration with lymphocytes and plasma cells and by this perivascular coughing of lymphocytes and numerous plasma cells. This together cause a narrowing and even obliteration of these vasa vasora, and this will lead to decreased blood flow of the media, and the media will be deprived of blood supply and deprived of oxygen and the nutrient, and this will lead to degeneration of the media and replacement of the elastic fibers and destruction of the elastic fibers and destruction of the smooth muscle cells and replacement by fibrous tissue, which leads to weakening of the media. Even the intima will show some subintimal fibrosis. And this subintimal fibrosis may give rise to a narrowing of the coronary ostia, the site where the coronaries, at the site of origin of the coronaries from the aorta. And weakening of the media will weakening and destruction and scarring of the media will lead to a weakening of the wall of the aorta and the distension. When the blood pumps blood to the aorta, it will distend and yield and dilate, forming the aortic aneurysm. Go to morphology. So morphology of syphilitic aortitis, and you know morphology means microscopic picture and macroscopic picture. This is the histologic section of the ascending aorta, showing the adventitia and the media, and showing here in the adventitia show inflammatory infiltrate, which consists mainly of lymphocytes and plasma cells. And here is the end arthritis obliterans. You can see it in the adventitia and in the media. You can appreciate it, the end arthritis obliterans, very beautiful proliferation of the endothelium and infiltration of the wall and thickening of the wall and infiltration by lymphocytes and plasma cells. And you can see this perivascular cuffing with consists mainly of plasma cells. See, mainly plasma cells and lymphocytes. Okay. In rare cases, you can see treponema pallidum organisms. This is thin, coiled structures. It may be identified in aortic tissue in rare cases, and you can see it with the Wilson starry silver technique. This is granulomatous inflammation of the vasa vasora, which caused fibrosis and weakness of the aortic wall. And here you can see broken elastic fibers. This is the media with broken elastic fibers. Very beautiful. This is inflammation of the vasa vasorum. Beautiful inflammation with the perivascular cuffing, and the vessel is nearly obliterated. See, the vessels are nearly obliterated and surrounded by perivascular cuffing. Very beautiful, consists mainly of plasma cells and lymphocytes. And this weakness of the media and fibrosis of the media and destruction of the elastic fibers will lead to shrinkage of the media, and this wrinkling will lead to wrinkling of the intima. See, the intima will be wrinkled because of the weakness of the media. The intima will be wrinkled. See, this wrinkling will give rise to elevations and furrow in the intima. So this will be reflected on the gross picture of the intima. So if this is the gross picture of syphilitic aortitis, and you can see roughened endothelium, roughened intima. The intima is rough with fine and coarse wrinkling and irregularities caused by the scattered inflammation and the fibrosis. And this gives rise to the characteristic three-park appearance. You will appreciate the three-park appearance in this picture. This is the Vangison stain, and you can see beautiful three-park appearance. This is the intima with multiple gelatinous plaques, and these plaques are separated by scars and vertical furrows, giving rise to the characteristic three-park appearance. Very beautiful. See the gelatinous areas, gelatinous plaques, and it is separated by these vertical furrows and these scars. And you can see some plaques are yellow in color, and this is due to superimposed atherosclerosis. This also pictures of the three-park appearance in syphilitic aortitis. Very beautiful. And here you can see the media replaced by fibrous tissue. And here you can see the adventitia with endarthritis obliterans. And here is the inflammation of the aorta. And this is the perivascular cuffing. The arrow points to the perivascular cuffing of inflammatory infiltrate rich in plasma cells. Go to the heart. The heart is affected in cardiovascular syphilis in many ways. You may see aortic valve incompetence, and you may see coronary artery stenosis, and you may see diffuse myocarditis and pericarditis with inflammatory infiltrate of lymphocytes and plasma cells, and you may see gamma in the septum, particularly in the ventricular septum, in the interventricular septum. So, why there is aortic valve incompetence? What causes aortic valve incompetence? you know that the aorta becomes weakened and dilate. And when the aorta are weak and dilate, this will lead to widening of the aortic ring. And this causes aortic valve incompetence because of the widening of the aortic ring. But the cusps themselves may be affected. So aortic valve incompetence may occur due to widening of the aortic ring, which is caused by widening of and dilatation of the aorta, which is caused by fibrosis of the media, or it may be caused by affection of the cusps themselves by syphilitic reaction, and shortening of the cusps, fibrosis and the shortening of the cusps will lead to aortic valve incompetence. Coronary artery stenosis. Go to coronary arteries. Coronary arteries may be affected in two ways. It may be affected by narrowing at their ostia, at their origin from the aorta, by the subintimal fibrosis. Subintimal fibrosis may affect the mouth of the coronary ostia and lead to stenosis. Here is the cardiac catheter showing narrowing in the left main coronary artery ostia. So this is left main coronary artery ostial stenosis. But the coronary arteries may also be affected by syphilitic arthritis, by affection of the wall of the coronary vessels. This is syphilitic arthritis, and you can see thickening of the wall of the, this is the right coronary, but it may occur in the right coronary, in the left coronary, or in both of them, any coronary may be affected. This is thickening of the wall of the right coronary artery, as you can see, and here is the media showing inflammatory infiltrate, and this is fibrosis of the media, and this is the adventitia showing fibrosis, and also it shows this end arthritis obliterans. And here you can see the inflammatory infiltrate consists mainly of lymphocytes and plasma cells. Affection of the coronary artery by stenosis will give rise to gradual ischemia. This gradual ischemia may give rise to myocardial fibrosis. It gives rise to patchy myocardial fibrosis. But sudden ischemia may occur due to thrombosis, and this may give rise to heart failure and sudden death. Thank you so much.